Yes, in this video, we are going to see the performance of the demand painting. So how we will calculate the performance of the demand painting? Because here, what we are going to do is, we are not going to load the whole of the user process into the main memory. So whichever page is rendered, only that page is loaded. So in this case, what happened? Since the required page is not in the main memory, when it is needed, a request for the page to be read from the secondary storage will be done. That we call it as page fault. That is, it will verify the by verifying the page table, the operating system find that it is not present, that particular page, when a reference is made, when the particular page is not in the, by verifying the valid and invalid bit that we have seen in the previous thing. That is, when a page is loaded, it checks whether it is present in the from the page table, it finds whether it is not present. How it will do? By checking the valid and invalid bit. So when it is invalid, then a trap to the operating system will be done, where that is, it is the page is not present. So how it can execute? So an interrupt will take place, which is nothing but now we call that as a page fault. So your request to reading an IO is initiated. So that we call it as a page fault because it is not present. So it is fault. So now the operating system will initialize IO. It take the read the respective page from the secondary storage and put it in the physical memory. When it is placing it in the secondary physical memory, first checks whether it is a free frame. It gets the free frame list from the operating system. The operating system will keep a list of free frames. So from that it take, and that in the one of the free frame, that the page which is read from the secondary storage will be placed, and what is the frame number that will be updated in the page table, and this valid invalid bit is made as valid because now it is present in the main memory. So this is the process which we have seen. So whenever a page is not present, a page fault takes place, which is nothing but an interrupt, which asks the operating system to read the particular page from the secondary storage. So that is nothing but an interrupt, and we call that as a page fault. So the performance of the demand paging depends upon how many pages of an user process resides in the main memory. So for example, 10 pages are needed for a particular user process means, if there is no page at all, initially there will be no page. So each 10 times it has to request to get the particular page from the secondary storage, and it will be loaded in the main memory. Suppose imagine 1000 pages, 2000 pages are there. That much page fault will take place, and the information has to be loaded. Sometimes half of the user process may be loaded previously, in which case, say for example, 1000 pages means 500 pages will be there in the main memory itself. Only for the remaining, it has to do a page fault. Sometimes it depends upon the how much the user process is swapped at a time from the secondary storage. Okay, so how many times a page fault takes place? Based on that only, the performance of demand paging can be calculated. Whenever it requests a particular page to the operating system, definitely there will be an interrupt, and an IO transaction, that is data from the secondary storage to the main memory, will be initialized. So this definitely slows down because now the data is transferred from the secondary storage to the main memory, which is slower. So each time when a page fault takes place, first it has to be loaded from the secondary storage and into the main memory, which definitely slows down the performance of the demand paging. So if the page fault is more, definitely the efficiency of the demand paging is reduced. But once all the pages are brought into the main memory, then there will be no secondary storage access, only the main memory access. Now the speed is equal to main memory access. So in that case, the performance can be improved. So demand paging affects the performance of a computer system. To see how we have to calculate the effective access time for a demand page memory. So what is that effective access time? How much information can be accessed from the main memory? Okay, so while considering that, we have to calculate how many times the particular page is residing in the how much time a particular page is residing in the waiting queue also for a particular IO. That we will see in short. As long as no page fault, the effective access time is equal to memory access time, because when there is a no page fault, the access time will be only from the main memory. So it is equal to the main memory speed. So page fault rate must be, if it is nearer to 1, if you calculate the probability, if it is near to 1, then it will be every reference is a page fault. If it is equal to 0, then it means there is no page fault. Almost all the pages are in the main memory. So it executes fast. So the effective access time can be calculated with this formula, 1 minus p, that is number of page faults into the time memory access is done, plus all these things, that is page fault overhead, swap page out, swap page in, and restart overhead. What is this page fault overhead and restart overhead? When a page fault takes place, the registers, temporary registers, all those informations will be stored in the PCB. It is nothing but process control block. So in all those things, what are all the values? When a page fault takes place, what is the current position of the different temporary register of that particular process? Everything will be loaded in the PCB of that process. So when it is restarted, once that particular next page is loaded, the previous condition has to be restored. So in that case, the PCB, the data from the PCB will be transferred into the respective temporary register again. So that is called restart overhead. And swap page out and so on, the time required for swapping in and swapping out of the particular page. So a page fault, it causes the following sequences. So how it takes place? First, a trap to a OS. That is when a page fault takes place, a trap to OS, an error, an interrupt, it takes place. It indicates the OS that in order to execute the next page, that page is not now in main memory. So it has to be loaded from the secondary storage into the main memory. So save the user registers. So after the trapping, save the user register and the processing. So whatever the user state, status of the user, the different registers used by the particular process, all those things will be stored in the PCB. Determine that the interrupt process page fault. Now, what is the thing that causes the trap? That what interrupt has been caused? Is it because of the page fault or something else? So all those things will be considered. Then check that the page reference was legal. That is, it belongs to this particular process, and determine the location of the page. So now it know that a page fault takes place and that particular page is not there. Now it has to locate where it is actually present in the secondary storage. Now issue a read from the disk to a free frame. Now it has to issue a read from the disk and into a free frame which is available in the main memory. So in order to do that, what it has to do, wait in a queue for this device. Suppose that secondary device is occupied, that particular device is holded by some other process. Some other process is reading some data from the secondary storage. Now, after that that particular page has been read by other user, this user process has to wait. So now it waits in a queue for this device until the read request is serviced. So after the any other devices, any other process completes its page, then only this particular page fault will be serviced. So wait for the device. Once it is given the service, now the disk head, okay, it has to be moved to a respective page which is present in the secondary storage, where it has to locate in the secondary storage where that particular page. So in order to do that, the disk will be moved and the head, disk head will be moving on that, and the correct position will be made. So that we call it as a seek and latency, seeking time, searching time, and the latency. So that difference, the time, we will have called latency time. Begin the transfer. Once it is positioned, the head is positioned on the respective page of the secondary storage, now the data is transferred from the secondary storage, that is the page is transferred from the secondary storage to the free frame, which is already selected by the operating system from the pool of free frame list. Now, after that, while waiting, allocate the CPU. So when it is now the an IO is initiated, now the CPU will be relieved, because now the IO transfer, for the IO only initialization, the CPU is needed. After that, the device will take care of transferring. So at that time, CPU is not. Now the CPU takes care of some other process. The pages of some other process. Some other process will be waiting. Once they have completed I/O, they'll be waiting for the CPU tap. So now the CPU take care of that some other process. Then once the reading of the particular, the one what we are seeing now, this example, the page fault. Once it is completed, now it will indicate the operating system that it has completed the job of transferring the data from the needed page from the secondary storage to the main memory. So now it will be, how it will indicate? Again, it will be done by an interrupt only, saying that I/O completed. Now, once it is over, now the CPU, whatever it is performing, the other user process, now it completes that, and then it checks which are all the process are ready. Now this page is ready means now it will take, it will check its PCB and load the respective registers with from the PCB. That's what here we say, save the registers and process. Now before doing that, whatever it is processing, the other user process, that PCB, that other user also will be occupying the register. So all those things will be saved of its PCB, the other user PCB, and then determine that the interrupt was from the disk, correct the page table. Now once the page is loaded into the free frame, correct the page table means that free frame, what is the number of that frame that will be entered into the page table and other table to show that the desired page is now in memory. Now wait for the CPU to be allocated to this process again, and then restore the user register, process state, etc. from the process control block and resume wherever it has stopped. So before executing the I/O of that particular page, wherever it has stopped, it restart that process, and that page, particular page, now it is available in memory. The information in that particular page will be get executed. So the three major components of the page fault service attempt. So we have seen what will take place when a page fault takes place. Okay, the demand here, the major components of the page fault service time are the service, the page fault, major components in the thing, in the job, what we have seen, service the page fault interrupt. The interrupt has to be serviced, then read the particular page into the main memory, then restart. Wherever it has stopped, it has to, the OS has to indicate the CPU so that now CPU will restart the execution of the particular page because now it is available in the main memory. So these two, one, service and restarting, this can be done by careful coding. Okay, whereas reading page, it depends only on the I/O. So the page switch time takes close to 8 milliseconds here. The memory access time here, why reading page? Because it depends upon the say, for example, some other user process may be waiting for the I/O device. Now this page, which has to be read into the main, that request will be put in the queue only. So other user process, first they will be serviced before this user process gain its turn. So that is what called. So that we have to consider how much time this particular page waiting for an I/O is residing in the queue. So memory access time, suppose let us consider the memory, main memory access time is 200 nanoseconds. Then access average page fault service time will be considered as 8 milliseconds, where this average latency, given the average latency is 3 milliseconds, seek time is 5 milliseconds, and transfer time, so put together around 8, average it is 8 milliseconds. Let us consider memory access time is 200 nanoseconds and page fault service time is 8 milliseconds because of this. Okay, if a queue of a process, that's what I have said, if a queue of a process is waiting for a device, what is the queue of a process already before this page takes place? There are so many process, it is a multi-programming. So many user process will be having page fault. They also will be waiting for the I/O transfer. So all those will be put in a queue. So the CPU will take a request from that queue one by one, and it execute the request. I/O device will be serviced for those process. So if our whatever the example, what we are seeing, that process is requesting, it will be put in the queue, which is nothing but at the end of the queue. So it has to wait in the queue till it has its own turn, till it comes to the front. So if your queue or process is waiting for an event, then waiting time also has to be, along with this, waiting time also has to be considered. That is what making the difference. That is the second point, reading the page. So now if you calculate the efficiency, effective access time, then this is the given formula. So which is around, this is what? This is the calculation where the probability is nothing but how much page fault takes place. Okay, if on access out of 10,000 causes a page fault, out of 1,000, only one page fault takes place, then you can say it as 8.2 microsecond, which is small. But this itself is a slowdown by a factor of 40. If you want to reduce, if you want to increase the performance and reduce this degradation, then you have to keep the page fault less than 10%. That is, the probability of page fault should be this value. Then only the demand paging performance can be increased, or else it will be decreased. Because if it page fault for each and every page, then it will be a big problem. The performance can be improved by keeping other copy of the entire file image into swap 6. Already we have seen, other than the secondary disk, there will be the operating system keeps one more device called fast memory access device called swap space. So the whole of the user process, instead from the secondary storage, it can be bring into the swap space, and now the memory can, the main memory can access the data from the swap space. So once the entire user process is available in the swap space, the main memory can take the information from the swap space into its main memory. So accessing a swap space is much faster than the secondary storage, because in secondary storage the moving of head, latency, all those things will be there. But once it is swapped into the swap space, it will be nearly equal to the memory speed, main memory speed. So now you can increase the performance by keeping the whole of the user process in the swap space and then carrying over the demand paging, in which case it improves the performance of the demand paging.